So today we are going to be training this. To have crazy triceps, you must have a crazy mindset. The tricep, for most people, and that includes me, it is the most difficult muscle to grow. The tricep, it just doesn't want to grow. So when it comes to the triceps, you have to have a lot of patience and be consistent with your tricep workouts, or else you are not gonna see any results. It's so difficult to grow triceps unless you are a genetic freak or something. Okay, so I'm gonna start with my 100 push-ups and then we're gonna start getting crazy. This is my warm up. And another rule of thumb, it's funny, another rule of thumb, don't hold, never hold the bar like this. You see, like this, it's not safe. I've done it before, I almost died. Always make sure you lock it with your thumbs. So whenever you hold the bar, make sure you lock it with your thumb, not like this. This is not safe. Now I'm doing two 25s. So this counts as my first set. The first one was a warm-up. So as I've said, don't do this. Lock the bar. Lightweight. Let me try to tell you the story of when I almost died. So the thing was, I think it was last year, somewhere around last year, when I was still, you know, big. I was still a big guy, right? So I was used to doing bench press using the Smith machine. So with the Smith machine, you don't need a spotter or anything. And you can do that thing I was telling you not to do, where you hold the bar like this. So since I was used to the Smith machine at the college, I came here and the first week, I tried 225. I tried to bench press 225, right? So I was doing my bench press and then the bar hit this thing right here. And it fell on my left rib and it bounced off my left rib. And there were two guys, one guy on my right and on my left. They both came running and took the weights off me. That was the most scariest experience I've ever had. Because if the bar had landed on my face, I would have died right there on the spot. It was 225 and it bounced off my left rib. So ever since that day, I never hold the bar like this. I always make sure I lock it. It's a little bit uncomfortable at first, but it's worth it. So never take chances when you are in the gym. Because if you make a slight mistake, it's going to be big. Any wrong move is going to be big. So don't take chances. Make sure you are safe. Make sure whatever you do, it's safe for you. And if you want to go super crazy, find a spotter. If you can't find a spotter, it's best for you to go use the Smith machine. But make sure you prioritize your safety. It's not worth it. Trust me. Okay, let me do another one. Whatever you do, make sure it's safe. So I have to take my own advice and practice what I preach. So I'm gonna try these weights. If they feel too heavy, I'm gonna go for the Smith machine. Because I can't really ask anyone for a spot right now. Okay, let's do it. Woo! I felt that. Yeah, I felt that. So whenever you finish your workouts, make sure you put back the weights where you found them. And after re-racking the weights, make sure you clean. You clean up after yourself. You don't want anyone to do that for you. It's not cool. So don't leave your mess around for other people to clean for you. You have to clean after your own shit. There are some people who just don't do this. They use a machine and they just leave it without cleaning after themselves. That's not nice, you know, that's not what successful people do. Be responsible for your own shit. So if you want to succeed in life, be responsible for your own shit. Clean after yourself. It's not too hard. This is my first set, so I'm doing, this is 70, 115, yeah, 70 pounds plus 45, so that makes it 115, and remember, we are mainly focused on the tricep, so it's going to be a close grip. Everything is going to be close grip. If I do the wide grip, it no longer becomes tricep, it just becomes chest, so make sure it's close grip. Wide grip is this. And this is close grip. Okay, let's go. 1, 2, 3. Okay. This was quite heavy. This was quite heavy, but I think I can do more. So I'm gonna add 20 more pounds and see if I can do it. So if you wanna really shock the muscle, tear it down so that it grows to, they call it to induce hypertrophy or to activate hypertrophy where the muscle is damaged and it starts rebuilding. You have to push it. Always push it a little bit beyond what it is capable of. So whenever you are lifting heavy, just keep adding a little bit more weight, a little bit more weight, until you feel like you really can't do anymore without injuring yourself. So yeah, that's a good piece of advice. Keep pushing it. Woo! I felt that. Oh, okay. I think I've overused the word okay. Okay, man, it feels so good. I love it. But yeah, I've just added 20 pounds and I feel like I can add more. So I'm going to try to add maybe 5 more pounds, 2 5-pound plates. So I'm going to add another 10 pounds. This is how you induce hypertrophy. If you want your muscles to grow, if you want to shock the muscle, you need to push it beyond what it is capable of. Because if you only lift what you can lift, there's no reason for your body to grow. But if you push it, then it will take a step back and say, okay, this is not what I'm used to. I have to be big. So make sure that you are lifting a little bit beyond what you are comfortable with. If you feel like you can still go heavier, keep adding those gradual increments. They make a difference. So keep throwing a little bit more fuel into the fire. Not too much, but just a little bit. Keep feeding the fire until you can't, like, you really can't do anymore. So yeah, that's another piece of advice. Don't just go with the flow. Sometimes to grow, you need to be doing more than what you can do. So yeah, let me add more weight and see. And always remember to breathe. Dang. Okay. Okay, so I'm done. I'm done with the incline. So now I'm moving to the skull crushers. I feel like this is the scariest workout. It's called skull crusher, man. Skull crusher. What the F? But yeah, it feels dangerous. I don't know if it is just me, but I always take extra precautions when I do this workout. You should, like, it's called the skull crusher, man. So let me show you the skull crushers. I'm not gonna spend too much time here. I'm just gonna do one set to warm up for my dips and pushdowns. That's where I'm gonna do the most work. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are setting up for skull crushers here. Oh. So these are the skull crushers. So you are like, you act like you are crushing your forehead, and you have to be safe not to drop the weights, because if you drop them, they're gonna come right straight in your face and crush your skull. So another thing about skull crushers. Is don't lift super heavy. You have to prioritize perfect form. If you are a natural bodybuilder like myself, you have to prioritize perfect form. Every workout that you do, make sure you are using perfect form. Why? Simply to avoid injuries. Your main priority is to avoid injuries. Because if you are natural, you don't recover as fast, and you don't have the strength and capabilities of an enhanced individual who is taking performance enhancing drugs. So whenever you are lifting as a natural bodybuilder, prioritize being safe and don't lift super crazy. Never feed your ego, because that shit will only get you hurt. So don't compete with anyone. compete with yourself. Don't take performance enhancing drugs. It's not necessary if you are not a competitive bodybuilder, or if you are not gonna make money out of it. Even if you are going to make money out of it, I just think I'm at a point in my life where I still think it's not worth it, because the results that I want to get, I'm getting them naturally. So for me, there's no reason for me to take drugs, because my natural testosterone, I feel like it's enough for my ambitions right now. So yeah, always prioritize being safe. Avoid all injuries. Don't ego lift. Lift for hypertrophy. And to build muscles, you don't need to lift super crazy. You just need to lift heavy enough. Okay, with that being said, let me do another set. So, let's go. Dang. I swear to God, this is my last set. I know I lied to you guys. I said I was gonna do one set, and now I'm in the fifth set, and I've even increased the weights. I don't know. That's why whenever I'm telling you my plans, I always say maybe. If you scroll back to this video, you will notice that whatever I was telling you that I was gonna do, I was saying maybe I'm gonna do this, because I know I usually change my program, because I come here without a plan and I start doing what my body is telling me to do. So sometimes, I would say almost all the time, I end up doing more than what I was expecting to do. So yeah, if you can be in tune with your body and listen to what it is telling you. If it is telling you to do more, do more. There's no harm in that. If you were planning to do 10 sets and your body wants 20 sets, do 20 sets. There's nothing wrong with that. So I was planning to do only one set of the skull crushers with the 60 pound. Now I'm doing 70, I'm in the fifth set. It is what it is, guys. I'm a gym rat. I can't help myself. So yeah, But I promise you this time, this is going to be my last set. I promise. So let's do it. Okay. So this is what's gonna happen. I want to superset between these two workouts, but I don't know how I'm gonna go about it, because I have to film each workout separately. So it's gonna be tricky. Okay, let me just start with the dips, finish them, and then we can go to the push downs and finish them instead of supersetting. But next time, if you wanna do your tricep, it's best to superset. I'm not gonna superset just because I'm filming, but that's what I normally do. I superset because I don't want a long period of rest, like a long rest period between my sets. So I do the push downs, I come here, I do my dips, I go back to the push downs, I come here, and it saves you time. And it's more intense that way. So in the event that you are switching, you want to switch between two workouts, it's best to superset. It's much more fun and it's much more effective. Especially if you are heavy, like on the heavier side, you get to burn more calories that way. So yeah, you might want to try that. It's a good trick. Another thing to take note of is when you are holding yourself, if you lean forward too much, you are doing a chest push down. It's no longer, it's more like a push up. It's no longer tricep. So you have to try to be as vertical as possible to put emphasis on the tricep. If you lean too much forward, you're no longer doing anything for the tricep. You are doing chest. So try to be as vertical as possible. But if you want to cheat and, you know, keep doing the set, you can lean a little bit forward, but try to do it perfectly for as long as you can. Okay? I also have that bad habit myself. I love to swing. Whenever I'm doing tricep dips, I love to swing. It's fun. It's more fun that way. But it's a bad habit of mine, so don't copy me. I'm not a role model. Okay, let's go. So another trick, whenever you are doing the dips, try not to look down. Don't look down, because the moment you look down, you are going to lean forward and you start doing chest. So try to look straight ahead. Facing front, do your dips that way. Don't look down. It will mess up your whole posture. So try to look straight ahead. If you can even look up, do that. But don't look down. If you look down, you are fucked. I could say this is my staple. This is my staple when it comes to triceps. I would say 80% of my tricep development, it came from the push down, just using this cable. So if you were to pick one workout to stick with for the rest of your life to develop your triceps, pick this. If you were to do just one workout for your tricep, do that push down. This is the big deal. So never skip this. So this is my warm up, and I saw this video once a long time ago. It was Phyisique. So the way he explained it, he said, when you are doing tricep push downs, prioritize the bottom part. When you reach the bottom, pause for 3-4 seconds and then let it go. If you don't prioritize that, you are not gonna see much. So push down and then pause and then release. So you have to go slow. It's better to go slow. Slow and steady. So keep doing it. Don't lift super heavy. That's the thing about triceps. If you lift too heavy, you are gonna mess up your form. And it's best to use perfect form than to lift heavy. If you lift heavy, you are not gonna see much, but if you lift light weights but perfect form, you are gonna see a lot of good progress. Thank you. Oh, it's too heavy. It's too heavy. Okay. Thank you. this is my fifth set and my last one. So I wanted to say one last thing. When you are doing the tricep push down with the single cable, if you lift too heavy, you can do the push down. But if you do light weights, you can do a kickback. So let me demonstrate what I mean. Okay, so this is 20 pounds. I'm gonna do 30. So for the 30 pounds, this is heavy. For me, this is heavy. So I'm gonna do a push down. So this is a push down. Oh, I'm so tired. So this is a push down, right? And with my right arm. So the thing I love about these heavy push downs, it doesn't just do the tricep, it pumps up the entire arm. So it gives you like a crazy arm pump. It pumps up everything, the forearms, the bicep, the tricep, even the shoulders a little bit. So this is good as a finisher workout. But if you feel like you want to really focus on pumping just the tricep, you have to go lighter. So instead of doing the 30 pound, I'm gonna do the 10 pound. So since this is lighter, I can now do a kickback variation. Instead of just pulling down, I'm gonna kick back. Watch the difference. I need to go back a little bit further. Ooh. Let me see if you can see. So to do a kickback, I need to distance myself from the weight. Find the right spot. So instead of pushing down, I'm pulling backwards. Do you see the difference? First, the push down, I was doing this. Now, I'm kicking back. And then I'm gonna do the same for my right arm. I wanna sneeze. Oh, I failed. Oh, that sucks. Oh, I've been here long enough. Let me wrap this up. Okay guys, thanks for watching. Okay guys, so I've just finished my workout. This was my third day and I was focusing on the tricep. If you like this video, please subscribe and press the like button for the algorithm. I really appreciate you guys and keep following the channel as it grows, and let's get fit together and let's see where this journey takes me, man. I'm feeling pumped. My tricep look good. I don't know if you can see anything, but I feel good. So stay in touch guys and let's stay motivated. This journey, it never ends until we all die. So let's stay consistent and let's stay hard. Okay, I'm gonna call it a day. Peace.